Buenos días. It is a great privilege to be here in the Freeman House celebrating our class of 2021. And we're going to invite, we want to welcome the parents, we want to welcome our teachers. Look how great they look in the stairs. You know, our first Expo graduation outdoor event. Give yourself a round of applause. Hallelujah. And we're going to have our pleasure of the Legion by one of our graduates, Sara Perez. We're going to invite her to come to the stage. Put your hands together for our lovely Sara. Be careful going up the stairs. And we're going to ask everyone, parents, to please stand. Vamos a pedir a los padres que se pongan de pie en este momento.
Yeah. Oh, my God. This one?
You want to use that one?
I don't know. Okay.
Look, I told you, look up. Say, work.
Does it work?
Work.
Say hello.
Hello.
This one doesn't even work. Hey!
DJ.
Hey!
I know we live. Sorry, we live from Aspiration Academy.
Oh, okay, I just use this one.
The mic.
No.
The mic. Hello.
I know everything is going to be all right, but not that.
Good morning.
What do I say? Good morning.
Welcome to our class. Welcome to my graduation.
Welcome to the graduation.
Aspirations Academy. Join me.
Please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Woo.
You made it. She wants a graduate. She wants you to clap for Sara. She did a great job.
Thank you.
You may be sitting.
Okay.
Now, we would like to invite to the stage Yaceli Nunez, one of our graduates, singing the national anthem. Yaceli? Ahora la niña ya se le va a cantar el himno de los Estados Unidos.
Does it work? Stripes and bright stars, through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting. That our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land, for the free, and the home of the brave.
Thank you very much. Of course, you did amazing. Thank you, staff. You're welcome to seat. Thank you, our color guards. You're welcome to take your seat. Welcome, parents. You may be seated at this point, and graduates. Be careful. We want to remind everyone of the safety protocols, COVID safety protocol. If you feel like wearing your mask, you could stay with your mask. If you want to remove it, this is an outdoor venue, so you are free to remove it. We would like to congratulate the class of 2021 and welcome to all the parents and the graduates. Put your hands together for all the parents that are there watching you, that came. Our color guards, if you could put the banners back in the position, put the in the front. Understand. Out there. Sit over there. It is a great honor. You know, in the morning when I got here, I told Mr. Hobson, you know, the weather's going to be good. It's going to be cloudy. The sun is not going to hit us. But, you know, it turned out to be a great day. The sun is right behind, you know, us and you guys. So thank you, parents, for being here. Thank you, staff, for joining us this morning. It is a pleasure to present our principal address. Mr. Hobson has been at Exploration Academy for the last 5 years, and this is his first year as principal, and we are excited to have him. It has been a great year for our school, and I want you graduates to put your hands together for our principal, Jake Hobson.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I don't think they heard you across the street. Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome. Congratulations, class of 2021. Before I begin, I just want to say a few words in Spanish. Bienvenidos a los padres, a los estudiantes, a este lugar muy bonito, este día maravilloso. Estoy muy contento por todo estar aquí hoy presente para celebrar este día muy bonito con los estudiantes que están se graduando hoy. Bienvenidos. Welcome. Parents, welcome faculty and staff, honored guests, Superintendent Pert, graduating class of 2021, welcome. Before I begin, I'd like to say a few thank yous because putting this event together took a lot of people. So there's a lot of people to thank. First, I'd like to thank our parents and our guardians. You have entrusted your most prized possession to us, and we're so happy to be celebrating this day with you today. So thank you. Thank you, Ms. Malavis, our senior guidance counselor, for the countless hours that you have put into this work, sometimes working well into the night and weekends to ensure that our graduates had everything they needed to graduate today. So thank you. Thank you, Mr. Garcia, our other guidance counselor, for your dedication to our students, for your support, and for being the heartbeat of Explorations Academy. So thank you. Thank you, teachers, those who are here, and those who are watching us live from home or the school. Thank you very much for your support, for your commitment, and your passion for our students and for this profession. I appreciate you. Finally, thank you for the SLT members, our PA president, Ms. Canella, and our parent on the SLT, Ms. Lisa Sherry, for whom we are very grateful because she was the one who found this location and she pushed for us to be here today. So thank you. Incidentally, she gave me a little gift today. These letters have defined the work that we did this year, so I appreciate it. Thank you to the tech team for being here so early in the morning to set this up so our students, our parents, and our faculty can watch us live from home. And thank you, Mr. Barreto, the head of our tech team. Incidentally, Mr. Barreto received the award of Future Engineer Teacher of the Year Award. He was on the news last night, so we have a celebrity among us. So. Congratulations. Now it is time to acknowledge the stars among us and those stars that are watching from home. The 2021 graduates of Explorations Academy. Congratulations, graduates. You are my first graduating class as the principal of Explorations Academy. So this makes this day extra special and a little emotional for me. I am honored and proud to be addressing you today. Each one of you has made it here through hard work, perseverance, and your commitment to doing your best. When you began your high school journey 4 years ago, who could have imagined all the sweeping social changes like Me Too and Black Lives Matter? Who could have imagined that we would be experiencing a global pandemic, one that hit our hometown harder than anywhere else? This pandemic took you away from your friends, changed the way you learn, and kept you from having the senior year that you had hoped for. This year, two-thirds of your classmates were studying remotely, and you spent the whole day wearing a mask and eating your lunch in the classroom, not to mention the prom and the senior trip that you weren't allowed to have. However, through it all, you have shown resilience and determination, and you have arrived at this milestone today. Congratulations. So today we celebrate you, what you have achieved, how much you have grown and matured, all the experiences that you have had in the last 4 years. Mighty Expo seniors, you did it. The one thing, thank you, they deserve the applause. The one thing I can promise you though, having lived a few more years than you have, just a few, is that these are not the last challenges that you will face as you continue your studies and you all move into the workforce. So when you're faced with obstacles and adversities, always remember, back in your Expo days, you already met unbelievable challenges, and you still made it across the finish line. You tried new things, you compromised, you adapted, and you changed. But you never gave up, and that spirit is what got you here today. Congratulations. As you get ready to write the next chapter of your life story, our greatest wish for you is that you follow your dreams, find your passion, work hard, and take pride in who you are. You may or may not know this about me, but I grew up in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, in very challenging circumstances. I was raised by loving grandparents and a single mother who worked really hard to ensure that we had food on the table and that I had the things I needed for school. Growing up, my dream was to come to America, which I had only seen on TV and the movies. But against all odds, I found my way here, I found my way to college, and I became an English teacher. And today, I'm proud to be your principal. You see, coming to this country was my passion. And being successful here is the force that drives me to do my best every day. This is the life story that I'm writing for myself. It's the kind of story that I know you can write for yourselves. Just follow your heart and trust that you can do it. I know you can. And while you're finding your way, remember that you are a part of a larger community. Your family, your friends, this city, and this world. Young people, you are the ones driving the bus now. It is up to you to change the course of our nation and our world, to make it a better, more just, and more sustainable place for all of us. Be a part of that change. And you can, and you must, be an agent of change for the better, for justice, and for equality. Now, go out into the world and write your life stories. Follow your dreams. Raise your voices on behalf of justice for all. And reach out a hand to help those around you. Be kind to yourselves and to each other. And now I bid you farewell. Congratulations, class of 2021.
If I can translate all of that in two words, muchas gracias. Muchas gracias, muchas gracias, okay? It's a lot of translation to do, pero muchas gracias. It is an honor today to have our keynote speaker, and I'm gonna invite Principal Hobson again to the podium. He's going to introduce our superintendent, Renette Pell. Mr. Hobson.
It's such an honor to introduce our guest speaker, Superintendent Renette Pell. We are so lucky to have her here at our graduation ceremony. Let me tell you a little bit about our superintendent. Her family migrated from Jamaica, West Indies, but she was born and raised in New York City. Ms. Pell is a graduate of the SUNY and CUNY schools. She's a lifelong learner who is proud to be the first in her generation to graduate from college. Ms. Pell started her educational career as a teacher in Brooklyn. Then she transitioned into an instructional leadership role and became a middle school assistant principal. Ms. Pell was also a principal for 10 years in District 27 in Far Rockaway, Queens. With 28 years of experience, Ms. Pell is now the high school superintendent for District 7, 9, and 12. She's committed to providing school leaders with the tools they need to ensure our graduates leave high school with a rigorous and academic experience and the skills necessary to pursue and achieve their goals and dreams. She is currently a doctoral student at Russell Sage College, demonstrating that the quest for new knowledge never ends. It is my great honor to present to you our superintendent, Ms. Renette Pell.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Let me put this down. Oh, wait a minute. This is graduation day. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you. Thank you. We need this energy. So I am going to be brief, but I do have some important message for our graduates. But before I begin, I always used to start this way when I was a principal. I would like anyone who's sitting in the audience or at home who is a grandparent to please stand up.
Los abuelos.
Let's give our grandparents a big, big, big round of applause. Because of them, we are here today. Thank you, grandparents. Hello, graduates, family members, staff, and guests. As your principal announced, my name is Renette Pell, your high school superintendent. It is my honor and pleasure to greet you this morning. To all the graduates, we know that this has been a very, very difficult and challenging year. We know that this journey has been long, but guess what? You're here. You made it. Congratulations. You made it through a very difficult high school experience. Give yourselves a round of applause. as I said, I'm going to keep my message brief, but I do have three important things that I wanted to share with you. Number one, labels. Number one, labels. Unfortunately, we live in a society where they put labels on us. Labels by race, black, white, Hispanic, Latinx, describing us, short, tall, heterosexual, homosexual, male, female, religion, religious, non-religious. You from New York, you from Jersey, you from the Bronx, all, I could stand up here all day with labels. But this is the message I want you to hear. How you identify yourself is what all that matters. As my mentor always used to tell me, it's not what they call you that matters, it's what you answer to. Remember that. Number two, as your principal shared, I am standing up here as the first person in my family to graduate from college. My parents migrated here from the Caribbean islands, and they had that dream. They want their children to go to college. And my sisters and I are first generation. But I'm gonna tell you this, and I want you to remember this. If you don't remember anything today, the only place, I'm gonna repeat that again, the only place where work comes before success is in the dictionary. You're going to have to put in the work, no matter what you choose to do. But we are proud of you. We know that you can do it. You are sitting here today because you put in the hard work. The third thing I want to say to you, you are sitting here today, each and every one of you, because someone, some adult invested in you. The grandmothers, the grandfathers, aunts, uncles, your teachers, your principals, mentors, big brothers, big sisters, somebody invested in you. They told you to get out of bed and make sure you get to school on time. They made sure that you did your work so that you could be sitting here today and that you completed your high school experience. Now, you, each and every one of you, has a responsibility to do the same thing for someone else. It is your responsibility as young men and women who are getting ready to go into the world, college, workforce, to be a mentor to somebody else. Don't take this degree, this diploma, and go ahead. Turn around, grab someone else, and lead them along the way. That's your responsibility. We all have a responsibility to our community, to our high school students that are now following your path. So I encourage you to be a mentor to someone else. We are all proud of you. I congratulate each and every one of you today. I know that we're going to hear some amazing stories of you going to college, being entrepreneur, having your own businesses, just doing many, many different things. But the one story I hope that I hear is that you did something for someone else in your community. Congratulations. Enjoy today. Today is probably going to be in your book of life as one of your top 10 accomplishments. I know you're going to have many, many more. I'll leave you with this one quote from Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela says, "Education is the most powerful weapon that you could use to change the world." Now that you have finished your high school experience, go out there and change the world. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank Thank you very much, Superintendent Pell, for those beautiful words. Si tenemos que traducir eso en español es muchas gracias. Estoy contenta de estar aquí. Gracias por llegar. Buen trabajo. Muchas gracias. You know, I want the parents to make some noise. Let me hear the parents making some noise for the graduates. You know, we are blessed to be here. Unfortunately, last year class of 2020, was not able to have a graduation, and we know due to the pandemic, there were many other ways of doing their graduation. But this year, our principal, our ESPO family, we thought about a different way to celebrate this day, and here we are in this beautiful venue, and we want the graduates to now make some noise. You are here, you're celebrating, so you know, you guys make some noise for your parents now. Class of 2021. It is with great pleasure that I call one of my colleagues that have been there, like Mr. Hobson stated earlier, day and night, texting each other at a graduation yesterday, and making sure that our students have all of their credits ready for walking today. And it's your guidance counselor, your school counselor, Ms. Giselle Malavis.
I'm a little emotional this morning. Okay, good morning everyone. First of all, congratulations to the families, teachers, and staff. Buenos días, padres, maestros, y todas las familias que están aquí hoy. I would like to give a special thank you to all my colleagues for all your support throughout this year, and for being here for our students. Le quiero dar gracias a todos mis colegas por estar aquí para mí y para nuestros estudiantes durante este año que ha sido muy difícil para todos. I also want to give a special thank you to Mr. Garcia and Ms. Bruno, because without them, I probably would have lost it a long time ago, because they have kept me grounded throughout this year, somehow, some way, through all the texts at the nighttime, in the morning, at all times of the day. We have supported each other to make sure this year ends in a good way for all our students. Le quiero dar una gracias especial a mis dos colegas, Ms. Bruno y Mr. García, porque por ello este año yo he podido no perder mi cabeza. Ellos me han ayudado en este año con los estudiantes, con todo lo que está pasando, con el estrés de trabajar en la casa, trabajar en la escuela, y también tener nuestros hijos que también atender a la misma vez que estamos trabajando y ayudando a nuestros estudiantes. This celebration wouldn't be happening if it wasn't for you all. Thank you all for your support and commitment to our children. Class of 2021, you are the class of resilience, endurance, willing to face challenges, balancing out academic responsibilities, and also living through unmatched times, such as the COVID-19 pandemic, and the challenges our nations faced during this last 2 years. My message to you guys are, go out to the world and be yourself. I want you to know the world needs someone like you. Congratulations, Resilience Class of 2021. I'm gonna miss you all. You didn't have to. Thank you. So I would like to present, today she is not going to do a speech because she is very shy and she won't be able to do it, but I would like to present this plaque to our salutatorian, Angelina Garcia Sanchez. I'm sorry, Angelica.
They wrote it wrong. Congratulations, my love, okay?
You want to do this? Okay. Thank you. And now the moment I think we all have been waiting for. I met this student when she walked in Aspiration Academy 4 years ago, and it's with great honor that we present the valedictorian of the class of 2021, our number one student, Angelina Gavina. Put your hands together for her.
You want to use that one or this one?
This is fine.
Okay.
Okay. Oh. Good morning to staff, parents, teachers, loved ones, and most importantly, the class of 2021. Before I say anything else, I'd like to thank healthcare workers, teachers, and most importantly, all the adult figures in our lives for their hard work and dedication to keeping us safe. Quarantine turned our I can't wait till our senior year into are we even going to have a senior year? What was supposed to be a 2-week lockdown turned into a year and counting of learning to adapt to online school and being separated from our loved ones. Instead of being in a classroom with 20 plus students and seeing each other's faces every day, it turned into being half asleep in our first period classes at what Mr. Bisgrove likes to call them floating bubbles for 7 hours a day. All these physical and mental challenges we survived have brought us to finally reach the goal we've been working 4 years for, which was to walk across this stage. 2020 and 2021 was not rainbows and butterflies. Instead, it was a storm. But if you look at it the right way, we are the rainbow after the storm. As we stand here today, we are history. We have witnessed great changes, worldwide protests, the city that never sleeps finally sleeping. We have stories to tell our children and those who come after us. It has not been easy, but this serves as proof that we can get through anything. Though many of us wanted to give up, it's a good thing we didn't, because we can finally move forward into a brighter future. The only advice I can give you all today is live your life like Rihanna said. You truly never know when it's your last day on this earth. Love the people you want to love. Love yourself, live every day, not caring what other people think about you, and live every day like it's your last day. I can promise you that it will not be easy in the future. There are going to be so many obstacles in your way, but you should know that everything you go through rewards you in the end. It will be a lesson or a blessing, sometimes even both. So be at your full potential every day, and don't let anyone, even yourself, hold you back from your goals and aspirations. I want to thank all my teachers, including the ones who are no longer in the building. I truly adore and look up to every teacher I have ever had in the school. Thank you for always believing in me that I would be successful in the future, and being adult figures who greatly impacted our lives and pointed us in the direction we needed to go. Mr. Bisgrove, even though you hate taking credit for this, you're so hardworking and dedicated to helping us get to this point in our lives. Thank you for all that you have done for our senior class. Ms. Malavez, thank you for always pushing us and working hard to make sure we pass all our classes. We truly see your dedication to make sure we all graduate, and we will always appreciate all you have done this past year. Mr. Garcia, the most energetic person I have ever met, 8 a.m. on a Friday morning, and he's blasting the song Happy by Pharrell. We all want to thank both of you for being our motivation and rock for these past 4 years. You guys are the glue to our class, and we wouldn't be graduating right now if it weren't for you guys. Mr. Hobson, you strive to make our school a better and safe place for students like us. We want to thank you for all that you have done, and know you will continue to do so for students of Explorations Academy. Lastly, I want to thank my family, especially my dad. Oh no, I'm getting emotional.
Papa.
Thank you. Oh my God. My dad is the one who is always going to be the most proud of me as I stand on this stage. Oh God, I'm actually crying.
You could do it. That's not Papa. Tell him to get up. Stand up, Papa.
Woo! Oh my God. My family is my biggest motivation. Oh my God. And will always be. No words can capture the true appreciation I have. Thank you to my family for all the sacrifices you make to see me succeed, and I promise I will never let any of you down. Before I go, whether you are going to a two-year college, a four-year college, joining the military, attending a trade school, or starting a career, just know that wherever you go, you will succeed and end up right where you were meant to be. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2021, and thank you for all the memories you've given me. Good job, good job. Might seem crazy with my face. So sad she's here, take a
break. Thank you, Angelina, for sharing those beautiful words with us. Words that are inspiring, and I know that our seniors here will take those words to heart as they move on in their own journeys. It is my pleasure and honor to give this award to Angelina Gavina in recognition of the distinguished scholarship achievement while a student at Explorations Academy High School. Congratulations.
Okay, now it's Friday today. Yeah, that's why we're playing him, because I'm happy. It's Friday. So, you know, it's Friday. Hello. It is Friday. You know, it is a great honor to have one of our former assistant principal in the building, in this venue. But we would like to, you know, I want to say his name, Anthony McCurdy, but you know, we love to call him since I met him, NJ. So welcome, NJ, to my graduation. But it is a moment. I'm going to ask Mr. Vizra to come and introduce one of our former principal that is here with us, you know, during the last 14 years, 15 years, Mr. Jack has been with us. Ms. Hernandez couldn't make it today. We invited them both, but Mr. Jack said, I'm here, I'm going to show up, and we want to recognize him and say a few words about him. So, Mr. Biscro, if you could please come to the stage.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. Estimados, familia, bienvenidos. Assalamu alaikum. Esteemed families, guests, students, and colleagues, I will keep these remarks brief, but it is my happy duty to give some small dignity to the ending of a great career. Mr. Drock, it is my pleasure to speak on behalf of Explorations Academy staff and students. Yes, the graduating class of 2021. As we send you formally with great happiness, with our best wishes and gratitude along your journey into retirement, we take this moment to say goodbye and thank you. Parting is sweet sorrow, but we are also joyful at your well-deserved rest. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Drock has dedicated a lifetime of service to New York City and her children. It is right and proper to remember this man, began as an educator, a guide, a mentor, and protector, working with beautiful and challenging students as a special education teacher. Robert Drock rose through long years of service through the ranks to become a leader, first among his peers, and then as an administrator, serving for over 15 years as Exploration Academy's assistant principal. During the decades, sir, that we worked together, I have seen a man of great dignity, foresight, capability, and wisdom help us again and again to reach and raise up the city's young people in the most profound and difficult situations of their lives. You have led a capable team, one that will continue to struggle to lift children up and help young people like you. So it is right to turn to you, students, the class of 2021, looking back on the service of one man, looking back on the service of all staff and faculty who have helped you along the way and guided you and shepherded you through your most difficult places. Mr. Jock, we will miss your song, we will miss your voice raised, we will miss your energy and your kind words of wisdom. We will miss your short conversations that help the school constantly improve. We are grateful, and we are humbled by the gift that you have brought through your life's work. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your service on behalf of the school. Thank you for your service on behalf of the children.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. So, I want to thank Mr. Hobson. I want to thank everybody at Explorations Academy High School. I have been here for 15 years. It has been my life, my passion, my love. When I say love, that means when I look out in each and every one of you, it has been so hard not to be with you for this year. You know, the other day, I watched In the Heights. And even though it's on the other side of town, it brought a real emotional tear to my eye, because when I looked at, you know, what was, you know, that movie, I was like, oh my God, how much do I miss each and every one of you? You know, I started educating students in the Bronx in 1994, and I started off as a special needs preschool teacher. And every day that I went in, I saw the joy on each and every single little face. And every day that I came to Explorations Academy, be it a great day, a not so great day, or just a day where just something wasn't right, it made me think about how I could be a special part of everybody's life here, and how I can work harder and harder and harder to ensure that each and every student's life that touched me or I touched would mean that hopefully there would be a real success in each and every one of your lives. You don't know how much I appreciate this and how much I love each and every one of you and how much I love the school and how much I truly miss it. And I can only hope for great things for each and every one of you out here and for the school moving forward. Thank you very much. I love you all.
We also want to acknowledge Ms. Hernandez. She's not in the venue. She couldn't come today, but she was our former principal. And in case she's watching, you know, thank you for all the years and dedication you gave to Explorations Academy family. Thank you for believing in each and one of us and in your student. And thank you for the legacy you left behind. So if you could give a round of applause in case she's watching from home. Thank you, Ms. Hernandez. And now it is the moment, I think, that we all have been waiting for, in which we celebrate your achievement, your attendance, your awards. So I'm going to be calling a couple of your teachers to come, and they're going to be calling your name. We're going to ask the graduates to please, as you come up, be careful. Okay, we don't want to call 911 today. So we need you to take your time. Right, Lindy? And thank you all. So I would love to call Ms. Jimenez, our social study department representative.
Okay, it is my honor and privilege to present the first academic award in the excellence in social studies and showing excellence in social studies to Ibrahima. Congratulations. Okay, it is also my honor and privilege to represent Mr. Michael for our music program. He is remote today and could not be here. Okay, so congratulations to the following students for showing mastery in our music program. The first award goes to Yaceli Nunez. The second award for showing mastery in music, Emma Alvarenga.
Congratulations, of course.
And our third student for showing mastery and excellence in our art program, music program, is Adolfo Candia.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Jimenez. Good job, good job. Now I would like to call up to the podium Mr. Jimenez, one of our new science teachers this year. He will be calling the awards in the science department.
Congratulations, class 2021. It is a privilege to be today and give this award to the following students. Angel Gomez. Congratulations, Angel. Good job.
Congratulations.
My second student, Lewis. Congratulations. My third student, Shaniqua. Congratulations. Angelina.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, class 2021. Good job, good job.
We're facing the valedictorian, I'm sorry. We're going to continue now with Mr. Biscro. He has many awards, but let me call Mr. Biscro. I call Mr. Biscro. He's representing COSA, English, student leadership. So put your hands together for Mr. Biscro, please.
I'm very, very pleased to be able to call these names. I would ask the students come up while I'm calling them, and maybe we can hold applause until the end so that everyone can hear what the awards are and they can hear their name. For outstanding citizenship, Anthony, please join us. For excellence in ELA, please join us. Wandel and Adolfo.
You can stay here or walk over.
You can walk off. You did an excellent job, guys. For exhibiting exceptional leadership in our school community, Angelina, we are so proud of each and every one of you. For contributions in the letters, Chenille, Mary Chris, and Halima. This. You would always think that these things break, but they're so strong. And for exceptional work inside the field of advanced placement literature, please Lewis and Matilda.
Did I get everybody?
Definitely. Perfect. You never want to forget anyone. Thank you, folks.
Thank you very much, Mr. Biscrow. Now with us, one of our physical education teachers, Mr. Allison, presenting the Physical Education Awards.
Good morning. The two students getting the Physical Education Award is Wandel and Enna.
Thank you, Mr. Allison. Now presenting our math department's award, Mr. Burton. Put your hands together for him. Ms. Stevenson.
Congratulations to the following students for their excellence in mathematics. Anthony Valerio. Adolfo Candia. And Luis Rivera.
Together for them. You know, I want to say thank you to Lewis, because Lewis, throughout these last 2 weeks, has been a mentor, tutor. He has helped, I think, 9th graders, 10th graders, 11th graders with their math. Now, on behalf of the attendance committee, Ms. Stevenson will present the attendance awards.
Good morning. So we have Lewis, Adolfo, Halima, Justin, Enma, Matilda, Mercado, I'm sorry, Shaniqua, and Angelina.
Adolfo,
Halima, Emma, and Angelina, Matilda. Oh, I'm sorry. It's you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. And Shaniqua.
Thank you.
And now to celebrate the Academic Excellence Award, Ms. Malavis.
The first award is for Emma Alvaranga. Angelina Gavina. Congratulations. Angelica Garcia Sanchez. Sorry. Chanel Douglas. Anthony Alerio. Luis Rivera. Congratulations. Ibrahima Diallo.
Congratulations, my love. Congratulations, Ibrahima. Ashley Nunez. Matilda Acenota. Halima Dembel. Congratulations again to all the students.
Now to present our principal's award, Mr. Hapson.
The first award for student leadership is Angelina Gavina.
Congratulations.
The Parent Leadership Award goes to Maria Alvarenga. Is she here?
Right there.
You're coming up?
Maria's right there.
Come on, Maria. Beautiful.
María ha sido parte del liderazgo de la escuela por los últimos 8 años. Su hijo Mervi Alvarenga se graduó de la escuela y ahora se graduó su hija Emma. She has been part of the school leadership team for the last 8 years. Her son Mervin graduated from our school and now her daughter Emma is graduating. And unfortunately she moved to Long Island so her other son might not come to our school, but that was the plan. Vaya.
The American Federation of School Administration award goes to Luis Rivera.
Congratulations.
And the Blanche Schwartz Award goes to Emma Alvarenga.
Principal Annabelle.
Okay.
Principal Annabelle.
Okay. And the Principal Honor Roll Award medals go to Angelina and Angelica.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Now it's a pleasure to call for our English Language Learners Department, Mr. Francois, Ms. Aria, and Ms. Nin.
Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias. We want to continue with the celebration this morning. And we want to celebrate this time our multilingual learners' achievement and outstanding performance at our school. Queremos celebrar los estudiantes que están aprendiendo inglés como un nuevo idioma por su gran esfuerzo y su éxito académico a través de estos 4 años. Okay? So, we will begin calling the following names. Aleni Esteves. Angel Manuel Perez. Jose Angel Hernandez. Justin Mercado.
Congratulations. Ooh, sorry, intermission.
Adolfo Candia Cano. Ashley Nunez.
Jaceli Nunez. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much. I like this award, and it's for, you know, a student that, his brother graduated from here also, and it's Cut Being Good. I always usually say, good job, good job. This student was Cut Being Good at Expo, maybe somewhere in the school. Our school is one floor, and his name is Angel Gomez. Angel Gomez, you were Cut Being Good. Mr. Hobson.
Congratulations, Angel. You know, as I mentioned before in the beginning, we are so lucky to be here today in this beautiful venue. It's our first outdoor graduation, and we've had such a beautiful day. So many people showed up for it, so we're so happy. But we need to thank the person that actually found the venue and pushed me with phone calls, text messages every day. Have you paid for the place yet? Have you paid for the place yet? And then I said, yes, I did. We are good to go. So let's thank and in appreciation, Ms. Lisa Sherry. Please come on up.
Did you pay for the place yet?
The place is paid for.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Congratulations, everyone.
Hello, hello, where are you going?
These beautiful, these are the last awards, and they are on behalf of our PTA and the school leadership team, and this is for the top A students in the graduating class. And we would like to call Wandel Perez. Luis Rivera. Emma Alvarenga Mejibal. Shaniqua Ham. Alina Dembel. Angel Gomez. Sara Perez. Alaney Esteves. Take it easy, it's Alaney. Matilda Asamota. Last but not definitely least, Ibrahima Diallo. Congratulations!
Congratulations. Every little thing gonna be all right.
Every little thing is gonna be all right. So parents, Please do not come all the way over here. You could take pictures from your feet. Now we're going to be calling a graduate. We're going to welcome to the foyer Ms. Malavet. She's going to be calling their name. And they're going to come by one by one. Mr. Hudson will present them with the diploma. And we're going to celebrate this day. Ms. Malavet.
So the first student, he's not here today, is Abu Koma. Emma Alvarenga Benjivar. Matilda Asenoka. Chris Baez. Adama Berry. Jason Bautista. Jaheen Brinson. Adolfo Candia Cano. Abdulay Chan. Marsarho Chan. Lindiana Dos Lopez. Halima Dembel. Ibrahima Diallo. Chanel Douglas. Justin Ellington. Aileni Estevez. Angelina Falcón. Angélica García Sánchez. Angelina Gavina. Ángel Gómez. Jairo Guzmán. Shaniqua Ham. Jose Ángel Hernández. Lauren Huarbe.
Justin Kahnheim. Congratulations, Justin. Josie Medina. Congratulations. Justin Mercado. But he's not here today. He's not here today. Jordani Montan. Ashley Nunez.
This morning, smile with the rising sun. Really before me, by my doorstep.
Jocelyn Nunez. Dania Peña Gómez. Sara Pérez. Wandel Pérez. Ángel Manuel Pérez Fernández. Matthew Pochard. Jordan Ramírez. Yvonne Richardson. Luis Rivera. Jose Sanchez. Maricris Sánchez. Starling Sánchez. Anthony Ulerio. Congratulations, Anthony.
Now we're going to ask the parents to be ready. This is the moment you all have been waiting for. The principal is going to make you official that you become the graduate of class of 2021. So we're going to ask you to please follow Tracy's direction. We're going to have you on the staircase facing your parents. This is going to be... Go down, ladies. Be careful. Angelica. Put them in the second one. Jordan, stop walking. You're going to go to the Bronx Zoo. Come over here. Boys. Mr. Hassan.
All right, so wave to your parents. This is the last time you're gonna be a high school kid.
Let me see. Face over here now. Turn around. Face Mr. Hobson for a minute. Now look over here.
Face me now, please.
Adama.
Are you ready? Okay, this is it. You ready? I think you are. By the power vested in me by the New York City and New York State Department of Education, I hereby declare the class of 2021 to be graduates of Exploration Academy High School. Now you may change your tassel from right to left. Congratulations.